do let me know. But this was the one that I
this we have gone through, sir. This we have gone through.
This we have gone through, na?
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
No problem. So, ये इस तरह का है. देखिए अब इसमें बताइए, इसमें सारा कुछ जो है ये सारा जो आपने पढ़ा है उसको यूज करके आपने अप्लाई करना है.
Right,
इसमें यह है कि क्या कहते हैं, अब सम ऑफ यू आर फ्रॉम द फार्मा बैकग्राउंड, सम ऑफ यू कैन बी फ्रॉम द ऑटोमोबाइल बैकग्राउंड, सो वी आल्सो ट्राई टू गिव यू यू नो फ्रॉम डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स. अब क्योंकि लोग मूव कर लेते हैं, people from automobile can go to pharma, pharma people can go to FMCG and things like that. So that is a thing. So that is where, you know, one has to really see that there's sort of flexibility, that sort of mobility, that sort of what is called portability of our skills from one sector to another sector should also be possible or feasible, right? So.
Right, sir.
So, starting from the beginning, what we have actually done is we began with a training need identification. So that was the learning need identification. That was the first topic. What will be the issues that you would be having with the learning need identification? Are there some questions that you would like to ask? Yes. Anybody? Okay, so we had done something. Just a minute. Yeah. So, how do you want me to? Because today's session is going to be like a review of the whole paper. So how would you like, what are the questions, which aspect you want me to really focus on? Is it can I request you to share it on the chat box? Okay, or otherwise you can just unmute yourself and say.
What I'm just trying to tell you is, this is Ashok Panda. Yep. What I'm trying to tell you is, you know, it always varies, you know. For example, doing a training in NALCO and doing a training in NTPC or doing a training in SAIL, though the concepts are same, but you know, the clientele or the trainees' mindsets are a little different.
Yeah.
So in this context, what are the, I would say, key or core concepts that we need to keep in mind while training?
Okay. Yeah, Panda sir, first of all, good afternoon to you. And, you know, you have been an esteemed member of our, you know, society for a long time. While, large organizations have got well-established training centers, Steel Authority has got MTI at Ranchi, NTPC has got at Noida, and like that, others also have got. Now, one other thing which used to happen and which is slowly changing is that result orientation in the training was little low in the public sector, though there will be very good budgets will be there, and they will have many trainings, and training will be compulsory also, like in NTPC it was 1 week's training was compulsory for every level. So those are the things which training centers are also well equipped and all that. But what is there is that result orientation has been a little less. Ki bhai, aap training kar lijiye, और करते रहिए, वो साथ साथ चलता रहेगा, और परफॉर्मेंस से लिंकेज काफी कम रहा है। ये इसीलिए जो लर्निंग नीड आइडेंटिफिकेशन है उसमें भी परफॉर्मेंस जो अप्रेजल रिपोर्ट्स है वहां से लिंकेज ज्यादा स्ट्रांग नहीं रहा है। अब इसमें फर्क आ रहा है, पर मुझे करंट उसका नहीं पता कि कैसे कितना सिचुएशन है। तो यहाँ उसकी उस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की कल्चर समझना बहुत यूजफुल रहता है, और शुरू में जब आप इंटरेक्ट करते हैं तो उसको आपको उतना आइडिया नहीं आएगा। बट आई वुड ऑलवेज सजेस्ट दैट इफ यू कैन हैव अ प्रिलिमिनरी राउंड वेयर यू कैन एक्चुअली गो टू दैट प्लेस। Typically, if I go to an organization to conduct the program, I would try to go a day early. और पहले दिन मैं वहाँ के प्लांट को देखना चाहूँगा, लोगों से वैसे इनफॉर्मल डिस्कशन करूँगा। उससे क्या हो जाता है कि एक तरह से वहाँ का जो माहौल है वो समझ आ जाता है, और वहाँ के इश्यूज क्या है वो काफी समझ में आ जाते हैं। अच्छा, वो दोस इश्यूज कुड बी इवन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम से स्टील अथॉरिटीज राउरकेला टू आसनसोल टू अदर यू नो बोकारो, सो दोस आर द थिंग्स व्हिच इज ऑलवेज गुड टू गेट दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ यू नो आइडिया। इन द केस ऑफ प्राइवेट सेक्टर सम टाइम व्हाट वी डू इज वी एक्चुअली गो अहेड एंड हैंडल द सैंपल ऑफ द ग्रुप beforehand. For example, I had to do a program on managing self for Siemens. So I said, can we have some of the people? So the total number of people were supposed to come was 20, but I was able to have a 1 hour group discussion with 7 people, you know, who were present. That was about 10 days before the program. It gave me a good idea of what type of real issues are currently that will be there. So cultural differences are what one has to really sort of understand. Yeah. And no specific one model to use. Yes.
So I would like to ask one question related to the answer which you have just given. Manali, this side, as you said that prior to the session you used to take the preliminary round and you discuss with the focus groups or the set of group of people to understand the culture. So who is that person who selects the set of group of people? Maybe means sometimes if there would be like a biasness or partiality in order to depict some kind of mindset, don't you feel that it might hamper the exact TNA?
That is where the your link normally, if you are an outsider, if you are an external freelance trainer or you are coming from an agency, your link is L&D manager, and it is L&D manager who is able to sort of arrange that sort of interaction. And though there can be a bias, and it does happen once in a while, but when you ask him, you will ask him कि भाई थोड़ा सा variety, मतलब हर तरह का participant मुझे दे देना जिससे कि कुछ understanding हो। उसके बावजूद भी हो सकता है आपको कुछ और additional type के participants जब full group आएगा तो मिलेंगे। तो ये challenge होता है।
Okay sir, thank you.
Yeah. So we did this learning need identification, and then what we had done was we had gone ahead and we sat, looked at, how do we really turn the learning needs into the I would say program design. So program design mein humne behavioral objectives ka particularly wo kara tha, different types of programs or so also we had talked about, that is training events and or you can call them learning events. And then we had started looking at the design of the program. In the design of the program, we said at the initial stage we have two aspects. One is program profile and the second one is program schedule. So program profile is created right in the beginning when you are doing that initial planning, and then program schedule is created more close to the program. एंड प्रोग्राम शेड्यूल जब आप क्रिएट करते हैं उसके बाद यू गेट इनटू व्हाट इज कॉल्ड द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम. अच्छा यहाँ पर ऑब्जेक्टिव सेटिंग पर हमने बिहेवियरल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स पर भी करा था और फिर ब्लूम्स टैक्सोनॉमी पर भी किया था. इन दोनों में बताइए कोई स्पेसिफिक क्वेश्चन हो, एनीथिंग व्हिच कम्स टू योर माइंड
सर?
या
I've studied a lot after the batches, the lectures you took, but there is still a confusion to some extent when it comes to designing a training program and developing a training program. Could you please throw some light to highlight the key differences?
Okay. See, designing stage jo hai, usme aap matlab ki program profile aur program schedule. मैं ये दो चीज़ों को मानता हूँ कि ये दो चीज़ आपकी मतलब कि कंप्लीट हो गई हैं. तो प्रोग्राम प्रोफाइल बन गया है और प्रोग्राम शेड्यूल बन गया है, ये आपका डिज़ाइन स्टेज पर है. अब डिज़ाइन के बाद जो डेवलपमेंट है, डेवलपमेंट क्या है? देखिए अगर एक प्रोग्राम होता है और जनरली वो दो दिन का चार दिन का प्रोग्राम होता है तो हम इसके बारे में बॉदर नहीं करते हैं. पर ये जो एग्जाम्पल हमने ली थी जिसमें हमने कार के नए मॉडल के बाद लॉन्च करने के लिए वो एफर्ट करी थी, उसमें यही इशू आ रहा था कि दिस इज वेयर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द कंटेंट वाज ए वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर. जब अब हम कहेंगे डेवलपमेंट में क्या होता है, डेवलपमेंट में ये होता है कि डिटेल्ड डिजाइन बनाना है हर सेशन का, और ये भी देखना है कि whether we are having a classroom approach or we are having a e-learning approach or we are having a hybrid approach, right? So you decide on this aspect, then you say okay, let's develop the content. Content में देखिए दो aspects आते हैं content के. एक तो ये है कि say for example trainer material is PPTs. तो पीपीटी जो है वो ट्रेनर मटेरियल, ट्रेनर उसको डिलीवर करेगा तो ये पीपीटी तैयार है. अब यहाँ पर जो होता है कि जहाँ पर एक ही प्रोग्राम करना है वहाँ पर जो डेवलपर है और डिलीवरी जो करनी है वो वही व्यक्ति होता है. आपने डेवलप किया, आप इन्हें डिलीवर करा. पर अगर मान लीजिए ये हमारा एक प्रोजेक्ट है जिसमें हमें डिलीवर करना है ऑल ओवर इंडिया and we have to prepare the content and then get it delivered through n number of other trainers, to hum kya karenge? Hum jo karte hain usme pehle to content develop kar lete hain, phir jo trainers hain jo delivery karne wale hain unka bhi ek train the trainer program karte hain. Train the trainer program detail nahi hota, प्रोग्राम स्पेसिफिक होता है. इसको एक और भी नाम दिया जाता है और वो है बूट कैंप. तो एक बूट कैंप करा जिसमें वो प्रोग्राम को रन करा विद सम ऑफ द दोस ट्रेनर्स एज द ट्रेनीज एंड द डिजाइनर द पर्सन हु हैज एक्चुअली डेवलप्ड द एंटायर थिंग वुड बी एक्चुअली रनिंग द प्रोग्राम. तो वहां से फीडबैक मिल जाती है. उससे क्या होता है कि जो कंटेंट है उसमें मॉडिफिकेशंस अगर कुछ करने होते हैं वो सब कर लिए जाते हैं और फिर फ्रीज कर दिया जाता है कि ये हमारा कंटेंट है. कंटेंट में मैं आपको बता रहा था दो एस्पेक्ट्स हैं. एक एस्पेक्ट है ट्रेनर मटेरियल विच इज पीपीटी एंड अदर थिंग्स वॉट एवर दैट मे बी यू नो समथिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन. Those type of things will be there. The other is participant material. Participant material में participant को workbook दी जाएगी, उसको कुछ क्या session wise दी जाएगी या पूरा एक booklet बनाएंगे, तो वो participant material हो जाता है. इसके साथ साथ अगर कुछ exercises हैं जिनके लिए जैसे role play है, role play briefs हैं, self assessment टूल्स हैं, क्वेश्चनेयर्स हैं, इन सब का भी प्रिपरेशन और तैयारी करके करना होता है. ये सब चीजें जब बन जाती हैं और उसके बाद हम डिलीवरी से पहले अगर हमें ये बहुत जगह पर एक साथ करना है तो हम उन सब ट्रेनर्स को जिन्होंने ये डिलीवरी करनी है उनको बुलाकर एक बूट कैंप करेंगे और बूट कैंप के बाद उनको कहेंगे या नाउ यू कैन गो अहेड एंड गो टू डिफरेंट प्लेसेस एंड डिलीवर द सेशन। तो ये देखिए हम तो भूमि आपको आप क्लियर हो गया ये
यस सर
है ओके फाइन या तो दोनों में डिफरेंस है और ये वाले जो हमने लिया था एग्जांपल उसमें यही ये एस्पेक्ट सबसे बढ़कर आ रहा था ये जो कार मॉडल का लॉन्च करने का था ना जिसमें सर्विसिंग के लिए स्किल्स डेवलप करनी थी
टोटल
डेवलपमेंट जो है वो डेवलपमेंट स्टेज पर आता है। कंटेंट के दोनों पार्ट्स हो गए पार्टिसिपेंट मटेरियल क्या है पार्टिसिपेंट्स के पास क्या होगा और ट्रेनर के पास क्या होगा ये दोनों एस्पेक्ट्स वो करें और इन एडिशन और कोई रिसोर्स चाहिए जैसे अगर मान लीजिए डेमोन्स्ट्रेट करना है कोई चीज तो उस तरह के वो चाहिए जैसे केमिस्ट्री के लिए होता है केमिस्ट्री का कोई अगर मान लीजिए लेक्चर है तो उसमें वो उसे चाहिए वो बीकर है फ्लास्क है वो सब चीजें वो ऑर्गेनाइज करके आपको उन्हें देना है। तो इसी तरह से अगर आप कोविड पर कोई लेक्चर दे रहे हैं पैरामेडिकल्स उसमें उनको स्टाफ को कुछ स्किल्स दे रहे हैं तो आपको उस तरह की वो सब चीजें देनी पड़ेंगी राइट। तो ये सब चीजें जो होती है इसे हम इस सबको ऑर्गेनाइज करना अरेंज करना डेवलप करना फिर रन थ्रू करके देखना कि ये सब सही काम कर रहा है या नहीं कर रहा है ये डेवलपमेंट स्टेज का काम है राइट। डेवलपमेंट स्टेज कई बार ना हम जब छोटे छोटे प्रोग्राम्स होते हैं दो दिन का प्रोग्राम है एक दिन का है तो उसमें हम डेवलपमेंट स्टेज को और डेवलपर एंड डिलीवरी करने वाला क्योंकि एक ही है तो वो वहां पर कंफ्यूजन हो जाता है राइट राइट ओके राइट। सो नाउ वी कम टू
So one question that I have is Ravinder this side. So now as the exams are approaching, so like we've been given the books and we've also been clearly mentioned what the syllabus is. So if we go through the books, do we need to cover the topics that are covered under those chapters in broad detail or is it going to be something extra from that? I mean, I know like we need to study in depth, but yeah, that those topics would be enough or we need to do something extra.
Well, in a postgraduate program,
yes,
any book is never sufficient because postgraduate programs are never supposed to be book oriented, right?
Yes.
However, as I understand that, you know, many of you are at different places and at different with different type of, you know, like organizational support. Some have an organizational support, some don't have. There's also your access to the library, etc. is limited. So what one has to do is one has to prepare with a view that whatever you are learning and whatever is in that subject's syllabus,
yes.
How do you apply it in different context, in different sectors? So if you can okay. get examples of that and make yourself say comfortable with application bias, that always helps, right? Right. It is very difficult. Your question is very difficult to answer. Why? Because we just don't have a fixed syllabus. You know, this is indicative syllabus. But we are also again we are working on it. In fact, I'm there is a committee which has been formed, and I'm chairing that committee. we are looking at developing the content in the next month for different. So we'll have more detailed content subject-wise, paper-wise, mm-hmm. by the end of January or maybe in the beginning of February. So there is an effort going on that. But again, that also will not be complete in the sense ki aap kahein ki isme to ye cover nahi kiya hai to aisa kuch nahi hai. Postgraduate mein aisa kuch nahi hota. Right. Okay.
Sir, since you are chairing the committee for the content development ICD, just a request from a small request kind of. Since we are based in different parts. Also propose something wherein there is an online library kind of where we can get an access by being a member kind of, so that that is specific to students, and most of the books that we want might be a kind of if that is by any chance I do understand it is not something that can be done like in a very short period of time kind of, but yes, this is a proposal that would benefit more students
Yeah, good suggestion. This point is already under, in one of the points which we are trying to do it. For example, video content for the last semester and this semester are all available. Only thing is, we don't expect a student to go through, looking at instructional design. So if that is happening at 5 different centers, we don't expect you to go through all those. There is something called the concept of curating. It means picking up short parts of this and then making it available in a referenced manner. Reference means uska reference bhi ho or linking bhi ho ki ye yahan par ye wala point achhi tarah se cover kiya gaya hai. To wo aspect trick hai. It will not happen very quickly, but it will begin happening. So, and it will have you will have a I would say a better access to more this thing. And what we are trying to do is we are also looking at how all this can be also made accessible to our alumni also. Because aap log ye nahi ki aapne complete kar liya uske baad aapka कनेक्शन खत्म हो गया
नहीं हमें है आईएसपीडी के साथ
सो इवन लेटर ऑन यू वांट टू चेक बैक यू आर ऑलवेज वेलकम सो वी विल ट्राई टू सी दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ एक्सेस इज आल्सो अवेलेबल टू इवन द स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव पास्ड आउट एंड ऑल दैट यस सो सजेशन इज गुड एंड इट्स आल्सो अंडर कंसीडरेशन राइट ओके या
सो आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन
Yeah.
What I've understood is in design, it would be setting the objective. We will be going ahead with objective setting and also understanding what is Bloom's taxonomy. So our learning would be aligned as per the Bloom's taxonomy. So in design, we also would know program schedule.
Okay.
So when we are ending to conduct and etc. points, then what about the selection of the? It also can design or developing. Like I wanted to understand points. Like I was in the design developing. I understood that it would be more of the.
I'm stopping my video because I'm finding that I'm not able to hear you very clearly. So Sonal, can you repeat the last part of it that you? So there was some
internet issue
in the voice. Yeah. So can you repeat the last part?
Can you hear me now?
Please write in the chat. Sonal, your voice is not clear. Please write in the chat.
Sonal, write it. I'm getting the point where you are really asking. So just write it down, right? And I'll come back to that question. Yes.
Right.
So development part. And then we had looked at the whole issue of what is called transfer of learning, which I did in the last session, right? So, yeah. Any issues on transfer of learning? And I'm also waiting for Sonal's message, which it comes in the chat box, right? Or Sonal, you can phone me up and
Can you hear me, sir, now?
Yeah, I can. What you have written is, so, can we cover more specific design development?
Can we go more specific points into design element? Because there's so many things which have to be taken into account when design planning a project. So get to fin.
Okay.
Sonal, your voice is breaking.
Yeah.
That's... Oh, sorry.
Oh, no problem. No problem. I get what you are really saying. You know, what we can really do is we can look at that design part, you know, in a quick review of that, right? So I'll do that, right? I would, in fact, you know, we had done learning need identification. We actually looked at how to convert, though not in much detail with you, but how to convert the learning needs into a program calendar. That was one area which we need to do. No, the other one is that how to develop the, yeah. So how do we do it is, I would look at this. Okay, I would also look at this part, because some of you, the questions like Bhumi had asked me, they become very clear on with this. And this is actually what I'm calling is process view of the training process, all right? Process view of the training process. So what I am going to do is, I'm sharing this. Yeah. So what we have is, okay, all of you understand this, what a process is. A process is a logical set of activities to produce a defined output of value, and it has a discrete beginning and ending and has specific inputs and outputs. Ab isme ye wala aapne dekha hoga, input, process, output. So process mein wo transformation hai. Transforming input is getting transformed to output. We also have a slightly bigger one, which is called supply. Input, process, output, and then the customer. Now, in this, supplier can be a previous process also. It need not be only a human being. Customer can also be a next stage of the process also. So let's look at this. I normally look at the training process in six parts. It's slightly different from ADDIE. First is learning need identification. Second is planning training. Third is designing a training. Fourth is developing training content or module. And fifth is delivering training or conducting programs. So fifth wala jo hai wo aise hai jaise ki implementation. ADDIE mein jo implementation hai wo fifth wala hai. And sixth is the evaluating the impact of training. So isme aap ye dekhiye bataiye ki learning need identification mein input kya hai, kahan se aati hai?
Sir, it can be data and development center, or it can be in case of big organizations, or in case of smaller organizations, you can talk to the manager of the department or the head of the department.
Yeah. Okay, so interviewing the people, also performance management system.
Yes.
So from the performance management system, you get the input. And then what is the output? What is the output of the learning need identification?
Okay, what needs to be taken care of while, I mean, what all areas are there wherein the training is required, right? We get an identification of that. Which all areas need to be included in training.
Right. मैं आपसे एक जो एस्पेक्ट पूछूंगा वो ये कि अगर आपने ये कंप्लीट कर दिया लर्निंग नीड आइडेंटिफिकेशन और आप मेरे पास आते हैं और मेरे को कहते हैं ये लर्निंग नीड आइडेंटिफिकेशन हो गया, मैं कहूंगा अच्छा बताइए दिखाइए कहाँ पर है, तो आप क्या दिखाएंगे मेरे को? हाँ बताइए.
You will get the content for the training program, the subject for the training program.
No, sir. Chandralekha, sir is asking ki, whenever we are doing this learning needs identification, and once we are done with it, right from the input to the output thing, how would we say that, you know, this is the need? I mean, these are the learning needs that we have identified or assessed. So kind of report, I guess, sir. I mean, the way you said, you know, that while interviewing or performance management system helps us. So, you know, n number of things take place, and then we try to kind of develop a from the report we deduce what all are the percentage of you can say kind of percentage wherein you know there is a lack where the training. Okay.
तो आपको एक तो है कि समराइज करके आप दे सकते हैं,
एनालाइज करोगे, समराइज
होगा, पर समराइज के अलावा मैं आपसे अगर डिटेल्ड रिपोर्ट चाहता हूं तो आप मुझे क्या देंगे? आप टिपिकली मुझे एक डेटाबेस देंगे.
हाँ जी.
डेटाबेस में एक तरह से जैसे अगर मान लीजिए हम और ज्यादा बड़ा नहीं यूज कर रहे, हम सिंपली एक्सेल शीट पर ही कर रहे हैं, तो उसमें एम्प्लॉई के नाम होगा, उसका डिजिग्नेशन होगा, उसका एम्प्लॉई नंबर होगा और उसका डिपार्टमेंट होगा. अब इसे बाद में ये होगा कि इसकी लर्निंग नीड नंबर वन ये है, लर्निंग नीड नंबर टू ये है, लर्निंग नंबर थ्री ये है. मैंने कहा कि एक साल में हम दो या तीन से ज्यादा लर्निंग नीड को नहीं फुलफिल कर पाएंगे एक्सेप्ट इन द एक्सेप्शनल केसेस. तो आप मुझे एक डेटाबेस बनाकर देंगे. तो लर्निंग नीड आइडेंटिफिकेशन जब कंप्लीट हो जाता है तो सबसे बड़ी चीज जो है वो ये है कि वो आपको, आप मेरे को एक डेटाबेस बना दिया जिसमें सभी एम्प्लॉय का नाम है और सभी एम्प्लॉय की मतलब वो जो जनरल डिटेल्स होती हैं वो है और इनकी लर्निंग नीड्स क्या है, करंट लर्निंग नीड इस साल में जो हमने फुलफिल करनी है वो सामने आपने लिख देनी है. राइट. That is what is required, and that learning need identification जब complete हो जाता है तो database बन जाता है, ठीक है, right? It can be Excel sheet हो सकती है, it can be ये जिस organization में enterprise resource planning system है तो उनका अपना detail वो है, पर in any case you can get that कि this if you, this database should be able to give me an answer. Very clearly, number one, this particular person, what is his need? I should be able to put his name or his employee number, and here I should get the details. This is the person, right? Number two, if I want to do manipulation, not in the wrong sense, but manipulation in the sense, manipulate the database and try to ask questions. Ki interpersonal skills par kitne logon ko training chahiye? राइट. और किस किस को चाहिए? तो ये डेटाबेस में अगर मैं ये फिल्टर यूज करूं या ये मैं सर्च यूज करूं तो मुझे पता चल जाना चाहिए और मुझे पता चलना चाहिए इंटरपर्सनल स्किल्स पर ये 50 पीपल आर देयर एंड दिस इज द नेम एंड दिस इज द कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर, आई मीन दिस इज द एम्प्लॉय नंबर एटसेट्रा. सो आई शुड बी एबल टू गेट दैट, राइट? सो database in a form in which I can do proper analysis. This is the outcome of the learning need identification stage. Right? Okay?
Yes, sir. Right. Yes, sir.
या वेरी क्लियर ना, अब इससे क्या है कि बिल्कुल क्लैरिटी आ जाती है कि आउटकम क्या है, राइट? ओके, अब अगला कहते हैं, जो अगला है वो है प्लानिंग ट्रेनिंग। और ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस में ये होता है, कैसे होता है कि जब ये लर्निंग नीड्स मिल जाती हैं, बिकॉज नॉर्मली इन द बिग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दिस प्रोसेस इज डन वंस इन अ ईयर, राइट? लर्निंग नीड आइडेंटिफिकेशन को वंस इन अ ईयर करते हैं, राइट? सो करंट डेटा वो सारा कुछ मिल जाता है, पता चल जाता है कि इस साल में हमने ये लर्निंग नीड्स कर दिया। अब हम चलते हैं नेक्स्ट स्टेज पर। अगर हमने ये ट्रेनिंग वो लर्निंग नीड्स फुलफिल करनी है तो हमारा कुछ ट्रेनिंग की प्लान होनी चाहिए। अब ट्रेनिंग की प्लान क्या होगी? हमारी ट्रेनिंग की प्लान होगी कि हम कितने प्रोग्राम करेंगे, कब करेंगे। अब ये कहाँ से पता चलेगा? ये वहां से पता चलेगा जो हम करते हैं प्लानिंग ट्रेनिंग। इस प्लानिंग ट्रेनिंग का मतलब होता है कि एनटीपीसी में टिपिकली मैं उसका एक्सपीरियंस बता देता हूँ कि ये काम जो था ट्रेनिंग नीड आइडेंटिफिकेशन शुरू हो जाता था समवेयर इन सेप्टेम्बर, सेप्टेम्बर अक्टूबर में आवर पीपल विल गो एंड विल स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट दैट एस्पेक्ट, और अक्टूबर में वी मस्ट गेट दैट लर्निंग नीड्स अक्टूबर एंड तक। अच्छा, इसमें ये भी है कि जो परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल का साइकिल है, परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल साइकिल इज फ्रॉम अप्रैल टू मार्च, तो इसमें जो सिक्स मंथली रिव्यू होता है विच इज विच शुड हैपन एट द एंड ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर, राइट? सितंबर में जब हमें 6 महीने कंप्लीट हो गए तो वहां उसके बाद इन द फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ अक्टूबर और फर्स्ट फोर्टनाइट ऑफ अक्टूबर आई मस्ट गेट कि इनकी लर्निंग नीड्स क्या है, क्योंकि जो इन जो लर्निंग नीड्स का पर्टिकुलरली ज्यादातर जैसे मैं हमेशा ही सजेस्ट और फोकस करता हूँ कि जब फाइनल रेटिंग हो रही हो, जबकि आपका बॉस एंड सबॉर्डिनेट मतलब उनका इंटरेक्शन, और ये कहना चाहिए बॉस इज इंटरव्यूइंग द सबॉर्डिनेट, ये जो इंटरेक्शन होता है ये ट्वाइस इन अ ईयर होना चाहिए, और एक बार जो मार्च एंड या अप्रैल बिगनिंग में होगा वहां पर इम्पोर्टेंट चीज जो है वो है रेटिंग, और रेटिंग से जो अफेक्ट पड़ेगा वो कंपनसेशन एंड प्लानिंग, कंपनसेशन एंड बेनिफिट्स पर पड़ेगा। उससे पता चलेगा कि आपकी इंक्रीमेंट कितनी मिली है। अच्छा, उस टाइम पर क्योंकि रेटिंग का बड़ा इश्यू होता है, लोग अपनी जो लर्निंग नीड्स है उसको पूरी तरह से बताते नहीं है। वो सोचते हैं कि अगर मैंने बता दिया मुझे तो ये प्रॉब्लम है तो बॉस मेरे को 5 नंबर की बजाय 4 नंबर देगा, राइट? तो इसलिए जो लर्निंग नीड का फोकस हम हमेशा रखते हैं वो रखते हैं 6 मंथली, मतलब कि सितंबर एंड में या अक्टूबर में जो इंटरेक्शन हो रहा है, जो बॉस इज इंटरव्यूइंग विद द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, उस टाइम पर लर्निंग नीड का आइडेंटिफाई करो। तो वो जो लर्निंग नीड जब आइडेंटिफाई कर ली अक्टूबर में, एंड बाय एंड ऑफ अक्टूबर वी हैव गॉट ऑल दैट डेटाबेस पॉपुलेटेड, नाउ वी बिगिन टू प्लान फॉर द ट्रेनिंग कैलेंडर फॉर द नेक्स्ट ईयर। तो वहां से प्रोसेस चलती थी और हमें करीब 2 महीने लग जाते थे, नवंबर एंड दिसंबर, बाय विच टाइम वी वुड हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर planning of programs for the next year, right? Which is April onwards, right? तो वहाँ पर ये करते थे, और उसके बाद January में this used to get approved by the senior people in the organization, क्योंकि senior means director है, CMD है, all that people used to do that part of it, right? And then in February we'll try to get it printed. So if by end of February we have got it printed, March beginning में वो program calendar सब लोगों के पास चला जाएगा, and April onwards those particular programs will have to be done. तो जो अब ये जो planning training है, इसकी output क्या निकली? इसकी output जो निकलती है वो है training program calendar, right? Which is for the next year, right? In big organization, this process is very lengthy, quite complex, but it happens and it takes quite some energy and effort to complete it. All right? Okay. Can I go further? Any question on that?
Sir, so basically it is training calendar means the scheduling, right?
Training calendar means?
The scheduling of the training to be conducted over the year.
ओवर द फुल ईयर हम ये करेंगे और जो कैलेंडर जो शब्द है उसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि ये बुकलेट टाइप की होती है मेरे पास कोई एग्जांपल पता नहीं यहाँ पर है या नहीं एक्चुअली मेरे दो लैपटॉप हैं तो ये इस लैपटॉप में काफी चीजें ट्रांसफर अभी नहीं हुई है बट आई कैन शेयर विद यू लेट मी सी इफ आई हैव राइट ज्यादातर बुक्स में नहीं होता
अच्छा
और रियल लाइफ में ये होता है रियल लाइफ में ये एक इम्पोर्टेंट पार्ट है और बुक्स में होता नहीं है ये प्रॉब्लम हाँ और उसका रीजन है आई टेल यू द रीजन इज जिन्होंने जो बुक्स लिखने वाले हैं उनको ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एक्सपीरियंस कम होता है और जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एक्सपीरियंस जिनको होता है वो बुक नहीं लिख पाते क्योंकि ये एक वीकनेस है और सारी दुनिया में जो अच्छी से अच्छी बुक्स अमेरिकन बुक्स हैं उनमें भी ये जो प्लानिंग ट्रेनिंग पार्ट है ये एक्सप्लेन नहीं होता और ये होता ही नहीं है मतलब दे डोंट इवन मेंशन इट यू नो बट दैट्स अ वीकनेस यू नो व्हिच इज देयर राइट सो ओके आई डोंट हैव दैट पर्टिकुलर you know example but otherwise I can share with you,
sir while no problem sir but while I mean answering the questions in the examination just from that point of view for the actual point of view of practice in the industry we understood your point of view but while writing the examination I mean for papers we need to consider the format that you have taught with the for example ADDIE model or kind of like
कोई बात नहीं जो भी अच्छा लिखोगे तो नंबर मिलेंगे क्योंकि जो एग्जामिनर्स हैं जिन्होंने एवेल्युएट करना है वो भी काफी कुछ वहाँ भी बड़ा मिक्स होता है कई बार तो हम लोगों के पास ऐसे लोग होते हैं जो थोड़ा एकेडमिक ओरिएंटेड होते हैं और कई बार हमारे पास ऐसे लोग होते हैं जो प्रैक्टिकल होते हैं तो वो दे आर एबल टू एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर राइटिंग समथिंग गुड दे विल बी एबल टू गिव यू मार्क्स राइट
Okay.
उसमें कोई मार्क्स कट नहीं होगा अगर आप प्रैक्टिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से लिख रहे हो ओनली थिंग इज व्हाट यू राइट यू जस्ट गिव अ जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ दैट राइट दैट्स ऑल डोंट बॉदर अबाउट दैट पार्ट और अगर मान लो मार्क्स 90 नहीं मिले 80 मिले उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता सो डोंट बॉदर अबाउट दैट पार्ट यू नो राइट ओके
फील्ड लर्निंग इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट प्रैक्टिकल लर्निंग इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट
अब हम आते हैं डिजाइनिंग जो हमारा टिपिकल डिजाइनिंग पार्ट है वो है कि व्हेन वी आर कमिंग क्लोज टू द यू नो होल्डिंग दिस दैट इज वेयर वी विल लुक एट दैट डिटेल डिजाइन हाउएवर इन द प्रोग्राम कलेक्टर यू ऑलरेडी हैव व्हाट इज कॉल्ड अ प्रोग्राम प्रोफाइल तो वो प्रोग्राम प्रोफाइल आपके पास है वो प्रोग्राम प्रोफाइल्स को अब आप लेकर डिटेल वर्क करेंगे प्रोग्राम प्रोफाइल के मैंने आपको एस्पेक्ट्स बता दिए थे उसमें टाइटल ऑफ द प्रोग्राम है आपका इंट्रोडक्टरी पैरा है ऑब्जेक्टिव्स हैं कंटेंट है मेथोडोलॉजी है ड्यूरेशन और कब होगा वो डेट्स लिखी होती हैं प्लस व्हाट इज रिटन इज faculty, if you are able to identify the faculty right at that point of time, typically in most of the places in big organizations, they are able to identify the faculty right at the beginning, at least like a program coordinator or a program director, and like that it goes on. अब ये वाला जो aspect है यहाँ पर हम लोगों ने जो पढ़ा था वो पढ़ा था आपका आपका क्या बिहेवियरल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स और ब्लूम्स टैक्सोनॉमी, ये दोनों एस्पेक्ट यहाँ पर इंक्लूड हुए थे। और इस स्टेज की जो आउटपुट है वो क्या है, इस स्टेज की आउटपुट क्या है, यस एनीबडी हु वुड लाइक टू,
व्हाट अबाउट सेगमेंटाइजेशन ऑफ द एम्प्लॉइज,
दैट इज एक्चुअली व्हेन आई एम वी आर डिजाइनिंग द प्रोग्राम That time itself, we have been able to create separate programs for separate segments, right? Okay. So the output of this particular stage is that you have program design, which is program profile, and the program schedule, right? So that's the part that we have. Now we come to the next stage, which is developing. So developing की जो अभी मैंने आपको इसमें शुरू में भी आज बताया था कि यहाँ पर content completely develop करना, trainer material तैयार करना और participant material तैयार करना, ये दोनों तैयार करना और उनको run through करके finalize करना, और इसमें इसी स्टेज पर आता है आपका बूट कैंप करना और ट्रेन द ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम करना, ये भी डेवलपिंग में आ जाता है। तो ये सब हमने डेवलप कर लिया, हमने एक तैयारी कर ली और हमारे पास ये है कि हाँ नाउ वी आर रेडी टू लॉन्च द प्रोग्राम। तो वो जो नेक्स्ट स्टेज आती है, वो जो लॉन्च की आती है, इम्प्लीमेंटेशन की आती है, यहाँ पर आती है डिलीवरिंग ट्रेनिंग और कंडक्टिंग प्रोग्राम्स। अब इसमें कंडक्टिंग प्रोग्राम्स इज वन वे ऑफ डिलीवरिंग द ट्रेनिंग, द अदर वे ऑफ डिलीवरिंग ट्रेनिंग इज ई लर्निंग। जहाँ पर प्योरली ई लर्निंग होगा तो वो वहाँ पर ई लर्निंग से होगा, और कुछ जगहों पर जो कि मोस्ट अफेक्टिव मेथड माना गया है वो है हाइब्रिड लर्निंग, तो वो हाइब्रिड लर्निंग का मॉडल वो करके। नाउ दिस इज वेयर यू आर एक्चुअली डिलीवरिंग द ट्रेनिंग, तो यहाँ आउटपुट क्या है, डिलीवर्ड प्रोग्राम्स। प्रोग्राम इससे पहले वो आया था, कंटेंट हैज बीन द इनपुट टू दिस, एंड डिलीवर्ड प्रोग्राम्स आर द आउटकम ऑफ दिस स्टेज। तो ये जो है ये फिफ्थ स्टेज आ जाती है वहां पर, और इसके बाद हम देखते हैं सिक्स्थ स्टेज। जो सिक्स्थ स्टेज है वो है एवेल्युएटिंग द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ ट्रेनिंग। नाउ इसमें जैसे आप बाद में पढ़ेंगे और बहुत आप लोगों को पता होगा किर्कपैट्रिक मॉडल में फोर स्टेजेस होती हैं, तो इसमें जो जब डिलीवरी करेंगे उसी टाइम पर जो स्टेज वन का जो एवेल्युएशन है वो उसी टाइम हो जाता है, और जो स्टेज टू का एवेल्युएशन है विच इज इम्पैक्ट द असेसमेंट ऑफ हाउ मच हैज बीन लर्न्ड कैन आइदर बी एट द एंड ऑफ द प्रोग्राम और इट कैन बी यू नो विद अ लिटिल गैप, राइट? एंड देन लेटर ऑफ कोर्स यू असेस हाउ मच ऑफ दिस ट्रेनिंग और दिस लर्निंग हैज बीन कन्वर्टेड टू चेंज इन द वर्कप्लेस बिहेवियर, and then you start looking for the results that this change in the workplace behavior, how it has really led to some business results. So that part is that is where we get all that, you know. So first isme stage jo hoti hai uski jo output hoti hai wo sare ke sare raw form mein, to wo sare feedback forms hain. Ab feedback forms ko kaise karte hain ki feedback forms के ऊपर एक रिपोर्ट बना ली जाती है उसको एनालाइज करके, तो दैट बिकम्स द फर्स्ट आउटपुट। देन ऑफ कोर्स देयर इज अदर आउटपुट व्हिच इज हाउ मेनी पीपल हाउ मच हाउ मेनी पीपल हु गॉट द ट्रेनिंग how much competency they have been able to develop. So that is a result for in terms of participants learning. Participants का क्या मतलब कि क्या performance रही, right? How much learning they have done, right? So that is the second. And the third one, of course, is ki how much workplace behavior has really changed, which essentially happens from very different methods. There is no one way. For example, agar maan lijiye main mere paas 500 customer service executives hai, 500 customer service executives, badi bank hai. और हमने सोचा कि कस्टमर सर्विस एग्जीक्यूटिव्स का बिहेवियर उतना अच्छा नहीं था, हमने उसके लिए प्रोग्राम करके चेंज किया. तो यहाँ पर जो बेस्ट वे टू आइडेंटिफाई इज वेदर द एक्चुअल रिजल्ट्स हैव हैपेंड और नॉट एक्चुअली कम फ्रॉम व्हाट इज कॉल्ड द कस्टमर सेटिस्फेक्शन सर्वे. तो कस्टमर सेटिस्फेक्शन सर्वे कैन बी द वे टू असेस दिस. इन सम अदर केसेस इफ आई एम डेवलपिंग doing a program on leadership and उसका impact देख रहे हैं, तो हम देखते हैं कि भाई फिर उनका सर्वे अलग से किया जाएगा. उनका सर्वे जो करा जाएगा वो employees के लिए, employees के का सर्वे करा जाएगा, वहां से मिलेगा. So these are the six stages and there are different outputs, right? Any questions on this? Right. So, yeah. So who has written this? Okay. Ranjita. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Fine. Thank you for. Okay. Right. So. Now, your questions. Because we have been reviewing the whole thing, so I will be happy to answer the Dhananjay, you have raised the hand. Please go ahead. Yeah. Ask us, unmute yourself and raise your question. Okay. Right.
First question, that was in the launching of the new car model. Please give the learning objectives for some for a model. Please give us.
Yeah.
The first question you. Yeah. Launching of new car model. We are giving training to 2,500 mechanics and all.
Yeah.
For that, please give some one or two learning objectives for a model so that we can. I'm from the grower side, therefore we can have a model for people. Sir, please give one or two.
Right. So a person, a mechanic who goes through that program and has done it successfully, our objective is that at the end of the training, that concerned mechanic will be able to repair a car of that model, right? Now, in repairing the car, as it comes, he should be able to diagnose the problem clearly. Kis area se, dekhiye, you will have some symptoms, some vibrations is happening, something is not happening. So from that person should be able to, number one, diagnose the problem, right? Number two, having diagnosed the problem, he should be able to give the solution. Solution could be either replacement of a part or a repair of the part, right? So there is this, that he is able to decide, analyze and decide that this is the solution. That is third, he should actually be able to do that. If there is a replacement required, he should pick up that part from the store, right? and put it there and make the car workable. It was not working properly, now it is workable. Or if he is able to take out that part and repair it, sometimes, you know, it is a small thing and it can be repaired, he can repair it and then do make the car functioning again. So what is the objective? The objective is simple, that the at the end of the training program, at the end of the training, whether it is a training program or a training, this mechanic should be able to repair the car by, number one, diagnosing the problem, number two, analyzing and knowing a right solution, third, should be able to actually repair it, and fourth, if we can really say it is okay, hand over the car with right type of guidance to the customer. Because sometimes, you know, what happens is my engine has got into a problem. Now he can understand engine got problem because the person has really delayed his service. So he can, while doing this, he can say, sir, this problem happened because of you had delayed the, your regular service. So, sir, aap agli bar, please come on time and get the service, because if car is serviced regularly, it will never give you a problem, right? Problems will not occur, right? So that's the type of four things. So these are the things which you should be able to do, that's all. And this is what the objective would be. Is that okay, Chandralekha?
Thank you, sir. Very well said. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Right. Okay. Right. Okay. All right. Okay. So, more questions. Transfer of learning mein koi issue tha? Any issue in transfer of learning, transfer of training? No, if... that is not, that means either you are all clear or, you know, you are still to get your doubts when you actually study in more detail, right?
I have a small little question on this.
Yes, sir.
Transfer of knowledge. Actually, NALCO is here in Bhubaneswar, you know.
Yes.
I have done a lot of training for them also. Right. Mostly the trainings that were on creativity and innovations, then team building and all.
Yeah.
Once their management trainees join the NALCO, what I have seen, you know, for example, for the last 3 years, I'm doing training for their management trainees. Right. Now, what I have seen is, say, for example, you know, 30 people have joined the organization, 30 management trainees.
Yes, sir.
What happens after some time, I find, you will find in the class, for example, if you take a session for 3 days, you will find on the third day, out of 40, there will be 23 or 25. Then, yeah. You know, you feel amazed at what's really happening. And then what really happens is, when I ask them, they tell, some of them have got job in IOC, somebody has got in ONGC, and they have left. Now, this is a very piquant situation, because, you know, they have done training for, say, about 15 or 20 days. They have spent money, and after that, you know, these people, you know, slip off, and retention is not possible. Now, do you have any solution to this?
This is something, you know, which is a usual challenge to the public sectors.
Okay.
You see, in NTPC also, we used to have this sort of challenge that people will leave after some time, because let's all understand this thing. NALCO is losing people to the trainees, management trainees, to other organizations.
Right.
That means that the people who have been recruited in NALCO have good capability.
Okay.
Right? Mm. And the NALCO's recruitment process is good. Okay. Good in the sense that it does not have biases. It brings the talent. It is actually able to identify the talented people. Right? So that's a good thing.
Yeah, one point.
It is natural that they are going to lose this. I have found this because on one end I handle, sometimes these public sector type of groups, and sometimes, I have actually, some time ago I was handling a group which was a group of engineers, right. In they had gone through the UPSC, and they were All India Telecom Service and all that.
Wonderful.
Right.
Wonderful.
Now the point is, many of them were from public sectors.
Right.
Those who spent 1 year, 2 years in. Now it gives very good confidence to the public sector. That public sector, they actually, their selection process is rigorous and it is good.
Very transparent.
They are really selecting the, and it is normal.
No.
It is normal that you are going to lose some people.
Right.
Today in NTPC, see Avinash Joshi, who is a director here in ISTD. He was one of our boy in NTPC. And he went away to another organization. What to do? No problem. And similarly, Ajay Sahu, who is also from NTPC. And I was one of the so-called management trainees of HAL. Very few people from that batch actually remained with the HAL, but those who remained, one of them became the director of finance, another one became director HR. So point is, others also had the same caliber, but they chose to go away. But then those who went away, they are also there. So it's okay. Organization should not say that we'll really tie them up.
Okay.
Organization should feel that okay if
they are destined for ONGC.
You understand why
Go away
from one public sector to another public sector.
I know.
Really, the growth prospects and the perks are very good.
Yeah, clear. Very clear.
Very clear. So, ONGC, Indian Oil.
Right.
Right. So, they will take away the cream. Cream of the cream. Cream of the cream.
Right.
So, that is there. But then, and then, even many people have this, that they will go to IES and all that. Okay. No problem. And to that extent, NALCO has to keep this in mind. Some percentage, at least 25 to 30% will leave in within 2 years or 3 years,
right.
So that's something one should not bother about.
Right. Fine. Yeah. Thank you.
Problem will be if they are leaving because they find that environment is bad in NALCO. Then NALCO should.
That is different.
Right.
Actually, one very peculiar question I'll ask you.
Yeah.
When I have done a lot of training program for NTPC, on what subject? Communication workshops they conduct. I've conducted in Kurba, I've conducted in Kania, I've conducted in Talcher, in different places, even in the Eastern Headquarters in Bhubaneswar and all. Communication workshops and CSR. A very peculiar question was asked to me. And all these programs are generally for DGMs, additional GMs, and GMs. Generally, these communication workshops are directed to.
Yeah.
In one of the CSR programs, a very peculiar question was asked to me.
Yes, sir.
You see, sir, we went to the market to buy fish. And the cost of the fish was 200 per kg.
Uh-huh.
Some local people were standing there.
Yeah.
And I took a fish. Nobody was willing to take, and I took the fish at 200 rupees per kg.
Uh-huh.
But this local guy, they obstructed and said, NTPC ka bho jyada paisa hai. At 200 rupees they are purchasing fish. this guy would have given me at 150.
Okay.
Now, in this context, what we should do? That was the question that was asked to me by a general manager of NTPC in Kenya.
Yeah, yeah.
Very peculiar, you know.
I have a very, very, I would say, different view about the whole thing.
Right.
Because what's happening is, whether it is a public sector or it is actually a private sector,
right,
when they develop a factory, a plant,
right,
in such places, very few of them are able to really extend themselves to the local population.
Absolutely.
And that becomes a problem, then it creates a tensions.
Right.
And in this regard, I would like to give you an example, because, you do have these problems of project affected persons, PAP,
right. Yeah,
right. Or project displaced persons.
Hmm.
In HAL, when they went to Odisha, and you are from Odisha,
right,
and they created this plant in Koraput. And this is something which happened in 1962-63.
Right.
So what they did was, the first thing they created was not the plant. Mm-hmm. They actually created a training institute,
right,
for the mechanics.
Mm-hmm.
And they said that people who are children who have done 10th class pass or 12th class, will take them and will put them through the ITI.
Right.
And then they had 3-year program for them.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what happened?
Hmm.
Because the first thing that people came to know was ki yaha HAL aa raha hai. Or the second thing, that some of our children are already picked up by them for employment.
Right.
Now, what happened was that HAL did not face any opposition from the local population.
Right.
Because the local population thought that HAL is coming here, our standard of living, we will benefit from it.
Right.
Many other organizations have not adopted this approach, and then they get into problem.
Right.
And then, what happened in Singur,
right,
Tata project got into problem,
right,
and it happens private sector, public sector also.
Yeah, both.
They do the things not in the correct manner, it creates problem. Therefore, basic thing that people should really
extending your.
We are going there. We are going to become part of theirs, and we are going to tell them we are going to lift your standards.
Right.
So that's what we have to do.
Right. Thank you so much.
Right. Okay. Right. So some more questions, or if there are no questions, then I think I'll close it here.
So there is a question,
yes,
which I've seen in one of the old question paper. If you can just throw your insight on how to approach that particular question.
Uh-huh.
So I'll just give a brief. It says that the way Swachh Bharat Mission was it was started in India. So in some cities and villages, it was a successful program. And in others, it wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
So here it is being asked that you design and developed an intervention so that you can create a permanent change in the behavior of large population in a time-bound manner. So I was just thinking how to go about, the approach of the answer.
First of all, I'll ask you, do you like the question?
Yeah, definitely.
The question is very relevant. What is happening is, this is the reality, that we push certain things at some place, the behavior changes for some time, but then again, people go back to their regressive, right? Therefore, how do you create an intervention is multiple. The multiple would be that, yes, first of all, the way we are doing, advertising. Now, advertising alone doesn't really work. But the second thing that happens is the whole issue of punishment. That also works for some time. that works at the place where you they feel that the somebody who is going to catch them, right? But the places where they know that nobody is going to catch them, they are not bothered about it, right? Therefore, the sense of responsibility which has to be created and the value which has to be inculcated in the people about remaining clean, swachh, remaining swachh, has to be inculcated. So there is a multiple level. It is not behavioral only, it is actually a value inculcation. You have to create a value. Now the question of about how do you create a value is that not only you create the value right from the beginning, in the right from the early childhood, but there's also one more aspect that has to be really high. And that aspect is that economic aspect. Many places where they are dirty and all that are not so, because they want to be dirty, but perhaps they cannot spend that sort of time and energy for doing that. But then there should also be one more issue, which is a pride. Are we proud to be clean? Are we proud to be swachh? Right? So how do we create that multiple sort of, you know, things? Value, pride also is similar thing, and behavior change. Yes, policy level, we have to create a sort of, you know, an environment where also there is a punishment aspect also is there. So there will be several such aspects. Bringing all these together, we can create a clean India, right? Singapore was not anything great in 1965, but in 35 plus 20, 55 years, it was one of the biggest, one of the best places. So how do we, I would say, how do we really create that sort of desire and passion that my India, my country will become one of the best country in the world. So if nothing else, I can work on this one aspect, right? So that is how you have to really write. It is not easy, but it is still that simply by advertisements, it won't happen. Modeling of the behavior, that's also there. So if this big leaders are also involved in this, but then we have to also feedback, pointing it out. Anybody who is not doing that, somebody else who is passing by, whether he has that authority or not, can say, bhai, aap kyo kar rahe ho? Aap ye kyo ganda kar rahe ho? Right? So pointing it out and all that. So this is how we have to really do it and, you know, provide. So in a place like, you know, in our country, where we did not have even toilets, right? So how do we provide, right, the toilets? How do we provide the, you know, the places for the people to stay? It's a big challenge, but nevertheless, we have to be on it, right? And so that is how you have to create an answer to this.
So right. My content would be focusing on the motivation, the value, and the other things. I got the essence of the approach of the answer. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Right. Okay. So, and one training program is not enough for it, right?
It has to be continuous ongoing training program.
Continuous ongoing approach and, multiple set of people. Right,
I got
now,
it. Thank you so much, sir.
Right now, it is our, example, Amitabh Bachchan has been, used as, but why not all our dharam gurus, you know, they should also be saying the same thing. And of course, I know some of them are doing this. And so some of them are involved with the Clean Ganga project and all that. So involve multiple, you know, what happens is when you have to bring in social change, what is required is we have to work with the opinion leaders in the society. And who are these opinion leaders? That is what we have to really work on. India has been able to, our country has been able to bring about several changes, right? And always it has been using the opinion leaders, right? Most of the time, you know, that's how we have been able to bring the changes. So involve the opinion leaders. There will be opinion leaders in the mohalla, there will be opinion leaders in the cities, small towns, the villages. But when they are involved, then it starts happening, right? Okay, right. Chaliye, okay, I'll stop here and wish you all the best. Closer, see, we are just contemplating. At the moment, I cannot fully say, but we are contemplating our, you know, sessions are coming to a close. Many of them are already over. And with that, this session, today's, all your sessions are over. But would you like to have any revision session or maybe a doubt clearing session close to the examination?
Yes, sir, very much. So that, you know, for example, the transfer of learning, it's still, when you say that, are you having any doubts or are you still to have doubts? So yes, we are still to have doubts because we are still to study that part.
Okay. I'm recommending, and if this happens, maybe around, because your exams will start on 27th of January, 1 month from now, but somewhere close to that, when we have this around 23rd, let me see which is the weekend over there. Okay, we have this 23rd and 24th as Saturday and Sunday in January. We'll try to see that if we can have, opportunity for you people to get your doubts cleared. So I will bring in all our faculty members and we'll create some slots there so that a doubt clearing session could be there, because that's the time when you would be studying and you would have studied a lot and many of these questions will be there, right?
So that will be on a Sunday. That will be on a Sunday. That's right.
That's on 23rd is Saturday and 24th is Sunday. Okay. So somewhere around that time.
Okay. Right. Thank you. Thank you.
Right. We'll try to do it. Let's see. We'll also try to check with the people, maybe through Google Form or so. Ki bhai kitne logon ko zarurat hai. And if there is a substantial number who want, then we'll try to create that. Because maybe in some of the papers you don't have much of a doubt, right? So we'll work out,
sir,
the
mechanism. This is Dhananjaya. Uh-huh. I was not able to connect at that time. But there is one question that I would like to ask. Now, if there's a gap between our program design and the development that has been done for the designing part of it, and actually the training program being implemented, if there is a gap, then how, as a trainee, can I go back and get the thing done properly?
Okay. Yeah. As a trainee, you are at the receiving end.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. There is a gap. The gap can be on many aspects. Number one can be, I was put to a program, but that program was not designed for my learning need, right? I can tell the learning and development manager, this was not the right thing, and you did not get me to the right program, and my learning need is still not fulfilled. So I need a nomination to another program. Number two, it can be that while learning need was same, which I have, but the point is that the program was not designed in such a way that it did not have clear behavioral objectives And it was the content that was developed was out of place. For example, it can be that it was not in my context, right? And it was not in my context, and the type of questions I asked, I was not able to get the answer. So the point is, can you bring in a trainer or a which is more close to our context, right? Because maybe, you know, you are in a cement company and the person who came was from an FMCG company. So wo FMCG company wala aapko wo answer nahi de paya jo cement company ke liye appropriate hai. So you can say that, that whether the trainer was not competent or trainer did not have this sort of background, and the content was not developed for keeping in view our situation, or content was at a very high level. It can also happen that my level is low, or other way around, my level is high and it was like for bachas, right? So that's our sort of thing. So I can have number of these points. I need to then give a feedback to the concerned persons, typically the L&D manager, and also tell your boss, my learning need has not been fulfilled, so I need still to go through a program. Now the corrective action has to be taken by the person, and then you make sure if it is possible to go to another program, or if there is a remedial batch which can give you this, that is also possible.
So if the delivery itself, sir, it's not happening properly,
so the it will not be you only, it will be other people also who will say it, and usually it can happen. In some cases it can happen, and then you do have that sort of trainer or should not be used again for the program, right?
Okay.
So we do that, right? We have to see that trainer has to be changed, etc., right? So we have to take the action, right?
Sir, regarding the examinations, there is a short questions and essay type questions only. Is there any multiple choice questions? What's the model of that exam?
In the last examination, there was no multiple choice question, right? In the coming examination, I have not been involved with the discussion, so I have no idea, right? Okay. So
we would also like to know about the prerequisites. When would it be sent to the candidates, like the prerequisites for the examination? I mean, the other examinations that I am preparing for, they have prerequisites. Like you have to have this kind of system, this level of speed and kind of all those things are there. So are there any prerequisites that would be sent to us?
Okay. See, guidelines. Guidelines will be given to you, number one. Next thing, what was done last time was, because we were doing it for the first time, many of the students had no idea of how to appear in the online examination. So there were the mock sessions. So there can be, and there would be, okay, I will take it, because for your group, you are doing it for the first time. Yeah, I would write that there should be a mock session, so that you are familiar with how to register for the session, how to write the examination, what to do, what not to do. So there will be at least like about 1 hour session on that, right? Okay.
Sir, thank you very much. I mean, we really appreciate all your efforts, right from this mock test to, you know, asking all the faculties if they can, you know, arrange something for us on 23rd and 24th of January. Thank you very much. We really appreciate your effort.
Oh, thank you. We are here to help you. You know, that's there, right? Okay, chalo.
Thank you.
Let's close it, right? Okay. All the best to you, and see you again, right? Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank Happy you, New sir. Year.
Thank you, sir.
Happy New Year to you, all of you. Yes. Bye bye.
Bye, sir.
Happy New Year, sir.
Oh, yes. Happy New Year, sir.
Thank you. खाली हो जल्दी आइए।